Hi, my name is Victoria.
My name is Kennedy.
My name is Kaya Jefferson. I'm a rising senior at a predominantly white all-girls school in LA. In middle school, I found myself kind of changing who I was to try and make friends and try to fit into an environment that wasn't like for me in a way.
When I first started Archer in the sixth grade, there's only like one other black girl in our grade. It was really alienating for me because it was just the two of us and you couldn't just place all of us in the same classes. So for most of my classes, I was the only black girl in my class.
I was really like afraid of like being myself and like being comfortable with my like black identity because I was like, oh my gosh, I don't know these people. And like, I don't share my identity with a lot of these people.
A lot of the independent schools like to tout that they're, you know, 40% or whatever students of color. And I don't know the exact number for Bentley, but there is a pool of diversity, but the overall, you know, makeup demographic, I would say is white.
Bentley Upper School is vastly more diverse. It draws from, I think, 72 different zip codes. I know that 53% of the student body identify as non-white. It's a profoundly diverse type of community.
The way they speak, it's more focused on statistics because the numbers look good. For them to put out ads and, you know, have us in pictures where there's like three black girls.
On the outside, you wouldn't see it as truly looking to foster a community that is inclusive of students of color, just one that has students of color.
I think with students, there are not as many students of color, but if we also think about it from the faculty perspective, I think that there are far less faculty of color.
It makes it really hard to learn and to share and have a good, I guess, academic experience when you're not sharing a connection with, like, the connection sometimes is so, like, distant. When I have, I know, I guess certain teachers who are from different backgrounds, who are like from different white backgrounds that obviously I can't identify with. And I also think that it affects the type of curriculum that you teach in a class, because obviously if you have a diverse teacher, it's going to be easier to have a diverse curriculum.
In sixth grade, we had a geography unit. The project, it was like a get to know your ancestry project. So the question was like basically choose like a country where your ancestors are from and then share like how you connect to your culture. Like as an African American, like I didn't know what country I was from just because of like slavery and like kind of the erasure of like my history and my ancestors' history. So when they asked me like what country do you want to do, and I asked my parents, they're like choose some random West African country. So I chose Ghana, and I had to do this whole presentation on this country that like I really didn't connect to at all. And I had to write this whole reflection, I remember, about how I felt closer to like my ancestors. And I don't know, I feel like I felt really alone in that instance.
For me, what support would look like is like if I walked into class and every year a new class, and if I wasn't like, oh please, like let there be a person of color, or like at least one black person. Like I've never had a class with more than two black girls in it, like including me. I've never been taught like an academic class by a teacher of color. We never read books by that are by authors that are people of color if it's not about like oppression or racism or slavery.
You know, race is, if it's a conversation that you have every day, to me, it's normal. It becomes normal. So then it's not forced, and it actually become with, it's within your heart and soul, and you shouldn't have to think about it.
I think some concrete things need to happen systemically in the way that the curriculum is presented, in the way that, I'll just be honest with you, with hiring, and the way leadership is represented so that folks of color can see themselves represented in leadership positions.
I've never had like a black math teacher or like a black science teacher. A majority of, I guess, the black teachers are like in fitness. At a certain point, it's like, why are you showing me that that's the only way, like the only career path that I have?
If you sit down and take a look at a local accountability school report, it spells out that historically data across all four sites, African-American students are underperforming as a district. But if you don't feel connected to the literature, if you don't feel connected to the school, if you don't feel connected to the staff who are teaching you this information, then the lack of attention you will feel, and in return, put that into the level of work, you will lose a connection. Therefore, to me, showing the level of historical data that, you know, is astounding.
It's extremely important to have teachers that reflect the communities that they serve and the students that they serve. However, I think the big challenge is when you have a school like Bentley in an area that is not very diverse, it's going to be extremely difficult to attract teachers who would want to live and work in that environment.
I think anytime any sort of like issue about diversity would come up, I feel like the staff would look at the teachers of color, and it's hard to also bring that up to somebody that is essentially like higher up than you. And all you can think about is job security, job security.
Allyship should be shared power. It shouldn't be the dominant culture or the dominant group dictating to the non-dominant group how you should fit into the community. It should be really a conversation of, well, this is what I need to feel safe and to feel comfortable and to feel truly myself there. And I think that's what we're working toward.
I honestly hope that admin finally realizes that they need to be pushing uncomfortable conversations, that they can't be avoiding issues that have been around for a long time, and that there needs to be like essential reading for faculty, essential reading for students, especially white faculty and students. They need to have a basic education and training as to like what their privilege means and what their privilege means in the classroom.